All right, guys. Right when I was about to do the second flush, it started leaking water somewhere. I assume it's a radiator. So I am going to find out. And to be able to do that, we gotta take this cover out. Some of these things are already damaged, but they can still turn. Like that. Try to do it softly. Once you put the pin out, put them on a safe place, because these things, they can loose very quickly. And for this, all you need is a flat screwdriver and a Phillips screwdriver. So that way you can take all the pins out. All right. And we gotta take them all. It's about 4 or 5, not that many. So here goes the second one. All right, and let's do it. All right, so now we're down to the last pin. We can remove this. Okay, so now we're gonna remove the top cover. Easily, just like that. All right. Alright guys, using a 7mm socket, we're gonna take this bolt. It's a little bit tight, it's between the transmission hose that it goes into the radiator. So if you have a small socket, that would be very helpful. And what I'm trying to do right here is just to determine if the water leak, it actually comes from the radiator. Okay, so let's take that bolt out, and same on the other side. So I'm going to proceed to remove the bolt on that side. Okay. Again, this is right below the top water hose. All right, so let's remove this bolt, okay? Okay, so I ended up the last part doing it by hand. Now we got this loose, and we're gonna try to see if we can see through there. Okay, all right, so I was able to separate the cover, the fan cover, and I want to look through there to see where the water leak comes from, because it's kind of look like if it comes from the middle, I can see something wet in there. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna put water and see where the leak is coming from, okay? Because right now it's empty on water. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Yeah. All right, guys, so I'm gonna start pouring in the water. Okay, so right away I start seeing water down there. I don't know if the camera can check. I can see a little dripping there. That tells me that the radiator is gone. I don't see any leakage. So as I mentioned it, if you don't see any water leak from the hoses and you can see it right down there, the water, well, most likely it's your radiator that it's gone. Yeah, no, it needs to be replaced. So I assume the hole, it's right there in the corner, in the bottom corner. I can see the water dripping there really bad. I don't think it was the flush that it did that. I think it was just time for the radiator to go, because, you know, it was clogged, and I think it was just time to go. So I'm gonna go ahead and replace it. I'm gonna order online, and whenever it gets here, I'm gonna do the replacement, so that way you guys can see how it works. All right, guys, so we're gonna, I got the, like I told you, the new radiator, and I'm gonna proceed by removing the radiator out. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna loosen the all the hoses. A pair of channel locks will be very helpful for this. Let's just take them out, put it aside somewhere around there, and let's get to this big hose right here. All right, get it out. Yeah, these channel locks, they work really, really good when removing these things out. If the hose is really tight and it doesn't want to come out, what you can do is with the channel locks, softly, do not put too much pressure. You turn it like that, and you break it loose, and then you pull it out. By pushing it down, up and down, it'll come out a lot easier. Again, just try to put the hose somewhere around there where it doesn't bother you. Like that. Now I got the bottom hose. It's right there. And I'll do the same thing. Again, the channel locks. Oh, the camera is able to see that, but I'm removing the clamp, and then we're gonna get the hose out. Again, if you not drop pliers like me. All right, so the next thing is we're gonna remove the transmission hoses out. Now for these, you need a special tool to remove them. Now if you don't have the tool up hand, this is what I'm gonna suggest you to do. The new radiators, they come with the new fittings. So if you don't want to have any troubles right now and hustle later on, then we're gonna remove the we're gonna remove the whole assembly, and then it'll be easier for us to deal with the removal of the thing. All right, let's get it out. So in other words, these fittings are not gonna be good no more. There's a little bit of oil that is going to be dropping out. All right. and then the bottom one. This is just so we can remove the transmission. It's like a shortcut. Okay, so get it. I'm getting the bottom one out also. Okay. So once I keep working on this, it's a little bit of uncomfortable, but it's easier to do it this way and then deal with the removal of the hose. Okay, so I got it loose where I can get this with my hand. All right, so it's out. Okay, now we're gonna deal with this later. Okay. All right. So the next step that we're gonna do in here is to remove the top brackets, and this is gonna be done with a 10 millimeter socket, and we're gonna remove it. This is what's holding the radiator. Place, get it out, and bingo, that thing should come out easily. Right. So that's one bracket, and got the second bracket. It out. I always like to put the bolt on the thing. I put this back on, get the bracket out, and the radiator, it should be able to come out. All right, we got everything apart. See. Yeah. All right, so we gotta take it out. So we got this puppy out. It was leaking somewhere around there, I don't know where. There it is. It's the radiator out. We're gonna get a tool that I got in there a long time ago and I wasn't able to get it out until now. I got my wrench back. It was stuck there, believe it or not. All right, so right now it's a good time to clean the condenser for the air conditioner with water. If you want to take the opportunity to do that, the advantage of doing it right now, you can clean it. All right, so let's get to the new radiator then. Okay guys, so now for the removal of the transmission oil cooler lines, I have this little tool. It's this one. All right, it's got two different sizes. All right. So what you do, I'm gonna try to show you here on the camera. So this is what you do. I hope the camera catches this, but you put the tool like this, lock it in place, stick it in, and it comes out. See? So what this tool does is that it goes in here, and it opens up the it opens the ring and it pulls out. All right, same thing on the one on the bottom. All right, you just snap it in and snap it out. Okay, I hope the camera catches this really good. Sometimes the camera is hard to see it, but this is like this. You put it in like that, and then push it in, and that's it. It comes out. It came out. All right, so I got the bottom one too. I got both the transmission cool lines out again. Let me show you what this tool is. It's a transmission oil cooler line, scissor type, 3/8 by 1/2. So you got for both lines of the transmission. Got it at the automobile hardware. You can get it, and you avoid troubles. And the reason, to me, it's a lot easier to remove this because you can manipulate the hoses the way you want, turn it and pull it, instead of being on the radiator. It's a lot harder, believe me, especially for those who don't have too much experience like me. So this is the best way to do it. Like I said, the new radiator, it should come with new fittings, so we don't have to worry about those. All right, so now we got the space. When you remove all these, it's a good idea to change the belt if you haven't changed it in a while. I am not gonna do it today because I'm not prepared. I didn't buy it, but it's a good idea. I'm just gonna clean a little bit the cover before putting it in. I'm just gonna wash it and let's get to the new radiator. Let's see how it looks. It's pretty simple. All right, guys, so we're gonna get the new radiator. Awesome. Make sure it is the same as yours, that it corresponds. Now, there is two things that you need to check before you install the new radiator. The ports for the transmission fluid, they usually they're loose, so you got to tighten them up. All right, so we're gonna tighten this thing up. Otherwise, you're gonna have a leakage. It's gonna leak. Just try to make sure you tighten both. It don't have to be over tight. Now, this is plastic, what you're dealing with. Remember, if you over tighten, you can break them. All right. So I'll do the next one, tighten them up. Okay, so I'm going to tighten the one on this side. All right. So now that we got the ports tight, it's time to install the radiator. Now, you see these little pivots right here on the bottom? Well, you gotta make sure they go inside of each one of those ports right there. Right in here. There is one on the east side. It's like a little gasket. That's where it's gonna sit. All right, one on each side. Okay, so we're gonna install the radiator. Okay, we're gonna try to make sure we're gonna bring this as back as we can so that we don't damage the radiator as we put it in. Okay, the cover, you can. All right, so we are gonna put the radiator now inside the vehicle. Okay, guys, so I'm gonna put the radiator make sure you have it on the right direction. All right, and like I said, try to put the plastic cover up. Okay, all right, so I don't know if the camera captured that, but I got the pivot right inside, okay? And I gotta make sure that the other pivot is inside too. And I have to mess that side. Yeah, they're both on it. All right, so I'm gonna put the bottom hose first, which is the most difficult one in my opinion. You see how that slide, and then with the pliers we're gonna get the pins where it belongs in here. Okay, gotta do that first before we stick the transmission thing on it. Now for this action I like to use channel locks. They're my favorites when dealing with this type of clamps. They're a little bit tricky sometimes, but once you grab them on the right side, you got it. Okay, so I got them. Make sure I put it all the way. And make sure you pass the little lip that they have in here. Make sure you pass. That's what it's gonna keep it from leak, you know, for the water to leak. Now we're good to install the transmission. So on these lines, all you have to do is just push it and press it in. Try to pull it out to make sure it's on it, and then the next one on top. All right, kind of wiggle it. And push it just to make sure it's in good. Okay, try to pull it, and if it doesn't pull out, that means you got it on there. Okay. Alright, so we got those two knocked down. Now we're gonna come to the other side and we're gonna install the top hose. Okay, I had it previously down in here. It's real easy to put it in like that. We'll get the channel locks. Just 1 second. All right, so I'm getting the channel locks transported to where we want it. Wait a minute, it's kind of hard to do it with one hand everything. And see, now we got the hoses. All right, so now we're gonna install the clamps that it holds this thing up. I had left those bolts in there so that way I don't lose them, because I'm pretty bad for that. Put the clamp on its place and screw it in. You see how this thing just keeps it in place. All right. Okay, so if you guys remember, this was a number 10. This was a number 10 socket. Put it in. Ouch. All right. Now I'm gonna put the other side. Number 10. All right. So we pretty much got the radiator installed. Now we gotta worry about the cover. Okay, we have to put the cover like the way it's supposed to. Okay, so for these bolts, we use a number 8 millimeter socket. Now something happened with that clip. It's not there. It came without it. Let me see for the other side. It has the clip. Yeah, the other side it does have the clip. So there's it came without clip, but anyway. So now that we have the bolt in place, I'm just gonna screw it. Get this done. I choose to use a small wrench for this. Right. If it's loose, you can probably tighten it with your hand first and then continue with the small ratchet. Remember, we're dealing with plastic, so this thing, they don't go super extra tight. Just tight enough so that way you know that it is not gonna fall. Okay. Now, if in case you in case one of the pins are missing on your new radiator, all you have to do is take it from the old one. They're easy, come out pretty easy. Just pull it and then put it on the new one. It's not a big deal. I'm gonna put it on the new one right there, and like if nothing happened. So putting the bolt. Alright, so at this moment I am not gonna put the top cover, the plastic cover, because I want to see how everything works. I want to try it on, I want to see if there's no leaks, and you know, if everything is installed properly, and run it. And let's see, I'm gonna put the antifreeze. Don't put water, put antifreeze. Alright. Try not to drop this. If you have a funnel, that'll be much better. In this case, I bought 3 gallons of antifreeze. kind of probably going to take more. I almost forgot the top hose. It's in there. Got the pliers and stick it in there. All right, like the way it's supposed to be. Got the channel locks, amazing channel locks. They're good for everything. So at this point, I got the reservoir full, and I'm gonna turn on the vehicle at this time, so that way the water can circulate and start going through the engine, so that we can put the rest of it. All right. So we're gonna turn on the vehicle. For a while, so that way I can start throwing the rest of the antifreeze until it's full. So I got the vehicle running. I'm letting it get really hot. I'm checking for leaks on the hoses, transmission hoses, and everything seems to be in good conditions. Make sure the drain valve is also closed. Make sure that everything is closed, check the level for water, and you're probably gonna have to run it a couple days and start and check the level of the antifreeze, so that way you can put the adequate amount of antifreeze. Alright guys, so I drove the vehicle for more than 16 miles, and everything was looking good. No water leaks, no transmission leak, everything set on place, and this thing seems to be working really good. So now the final step is just to put the cover back on. Okay, the cover back on in place. So remember the pins. Okay, so we got the pins, and all you have to do is align it with the holes. Put the pins on it, and I recommend you to do all the pins first, and then the screws. Okay, so I'm gonna put all of them right there. Now that we got the all the pins in place, it's time to put the plastic screws, and we're done. Just be gentle on these plastic things because they're real easy to break. And bingo, so we have completed our job of removing and installing a new radiator on this Ford F-150. Alright guys, well, hope you enjoy it. I hope your project comes out good like mine, and I'll see you in another video.